Hi, Dr. Lim here. So today we are going to talk about herbs, huh? As I promised to you, we are going to talk about fresh herbs and herbalism. First of all, why should we learn about herbs now? You see, herbs actually is not like what you say that you have to go to the mountain, you have to go to the pharmacy to get it, you know. Herb actually, it everywhere, you know. Okay. Beside your house, in your gardens, in the park, of course, in the mountains, in the forest, beside the track, the roots, they're full of herbs. Secondly, is that in my herbalism, what I'm teaching to you do not need to go to the mountain to get the herbs. Okay, so you can go to the wet market, you know, to buy all the vegetable. Vegetable are herbs. This is the thing, you can go to the fresh vegetable. Lastly, of course, then you can go to the herbal pharmacies to get the Chinese herbs, to get all the herbs, this thing. So herbs are easily available. Okay, now why should we learn about herbs? Because herbs are something that can improve our health, can solve a lot of the problem. Like Zhang Zhongjing, in his preface to the Shanghan Lun, okay, the treatise to harmful disease, he said that everybody should learn about medicines. Of course, when he said medicines 2,000 years ago, it meant herbs. Everybody should learn about herbs. Why? Because in the above, you can go and treat your parents, you can treat the elders, you can go and treat the poor and have not. No, and he even mentioned poor have not this thing. You can also treat yourself, take care of your own self. That's why there's a good way that we should learn about herbs. Now, when we talk about herb, we have to mention two person, you know, that pass on the knowledge. One is my father. I'm going to tell you some of his story. Another one is Zhang Zhongjing. Zhang Zhongjing is a very ancient scholar, which is very famous until today. So we will talk about him when we go to this Shanghan Lun later. Okay. Now, come back to my father's. My father is a commoner. No? He's just a common as your father, as any elders inside the house. He's a commoner. Okay. 40 or 50 years ago, when I'm still small, I live in a village. No? That time, even in Alastar, okay, the whole Alastar have only two to three doctors that time, not like today. Today we are full of doctors around. Okay, and it's very costly, you know, to see a doctors. That's why in a village also, many people they just don't have money, you know, to go to see a doctors. So when they have problem with the room, then there is a few herbalists in the village. My father is one of them, and my mother is one of them. Then there's also another person we call Uncle Chong. Okay, sometimes I'll mention about him. So there are a few people they are very good in herbs. Okay, now. My father's, okay, he never go to the pharmacy to go and buy the herbs, everything. Okay, there is a railway track, you know, in front of my house. Near my house, there were railway tracks. So the railway, they have a reserve. Okay, a long, a lot. So my father used to travel to work everything. So they memorize, no, they memorize the herbs by heart. So when they need, they know where to get the herbs. No, then also not far away from my house, they also have this rubber estate. They're also full of herbs now. And then whenever there's a need, he go and collect from the wild, okay, to treat the villages. There are a few selling features now. First thing first is that they never accept money. They will not take any money for any treatment, you know. Not even a token like sometimes people give some what they call the red packages. No, nothing. No, they will accept nothing. First, they will not accept anything for the treatment. Okay, my father throughout his whole life, no, he never accept any money in the treatment. So even during the most difficult time, you know, by the time bankrupt, you know, three times in his life, you know, very hard time, you know, economically he face a lot of harm. Even at his most economically difficult times, so he never accept any money. This thing, and secondly, you should teach people, okay, without cost, okay. Most importantly is that you must respect the herbs. In the early day, he used to bring me, you know, when he go to collect the herbs, this thing. So he is expert in treating the fevers. So in a village, when baby people suffering fever, they go to him. Then we will go to the to collect this haijing sa, this kind of herbs, herb ferns, no. Okay. So when I reach there, he tell me, son, this is a herb. Wow, I get excited, no. So I wanted to collect. He say, hey, wait, not like that, no. Okay. Actually, I saw him. He said, come with me, knee down, no. And raise the palm and talk to the herbs. Okay, say Hai Sing Sa. Okay, I need you, you know, to treat who and who is suffering for high fever, you know. Okay, I thank you very much. Today I have to collect you, you know, to treat him. I must thank you. First thing. Secondly, he say, I will only collect what is needed, you know. So he just collect what is needed and he stopped already. Then he come back. This is a very principle. First, you must respect the herbs. Secondly, you only collect what is necessary. You don't collect more than what you need, you know. And he go back and he pound the herbs, pow, big bunch of herbs, pow, squishing. We only about 50 to 60 cc, not too much, but it's very effective, you know. Very effective, this thing. My father told me, you know, do not underestimate the herbs. Okay, you as a herbalist know, when you put a herb to this thing, within 20 minutes, you know. Whether the herb is effective or not, 20 minutes. This a thing. One times, he failed in his business now. Wow, we are in a very big financial problem. His face is always sad, you know. And sometimes middle of the night, you know, he walking here and then talking to himself, you know. Oh wow, he's a very pitiful situation, you know. Okay. So one day when I after working, you know, I saw him beaming, you know. I say, hey, Dad, today you look happy, you know, what happened? You see, our neighbors, you know, the auntie. There's one auntie neighbors suffering from high fever, you know, and go to the hospital, everything, take the medicine for so many days. The fever still very high, but they never let us know. No, only after that, he's rolling on the bed, you know, become agitated, rolling at the bed, this thing, and started to talking incoherently, you know, that this is very serious stage already. Okay, so he collected the herb, pounced it, and dressed it. He said within 20 to 30 minutes, no, the woman becomes sober, stop this thing. Then within 1 hour, the fever is gone. Effective, no. Effective this thing. Then you only collect what is needed. I tell you the story of Uncle Chong. The Uncle Chong is more famous than my father's now. He is he know a lot of herbs now, and we learn a lot of herbs from him too. He is very nice young man, always smiling. One day, she is chatting with my mother belong the railway tracks. As I told you, belong the railway, there's a lot of herbs, no? Okay. Then we saw a beautiful herbal tree, the robata. Sat bo chao, we call it sat bo chao or this ti tao hua in a Chinese. The kind of herbs, the roots, very, very important, no? In a village, no, we don't have ginseng when this thing, no? So to boost our energy, the root is very good. And it's also good to treat the fracture or the wound. Also for the kidney problem, no? Already for the kidney problem. Beautiful, no? Wow, beautiful. Because beside the there's one drain, you know, beside the drain, enough water. Wow, the tree is beautiful. Same, both of them looking wow, praising the herbs. You see, the herbalists, no, they love the herbs, no. Okay, so when they see the good herbs, no, they feel happy. Then they talking, they praising, no, praising. So they and my mother, both herbalists, no, praising. Wow, what a beautiful this herbal tree is there. So I pass by and I say, son, come, look at this tree, majestic, you know, so beautiful. Look at this tree. Then I have some idea now. I say, hey, Chong Pak, Uncle Chong, why not we collected the herbs, huh? She's smiling, you know. When I say I want to collect the herbs, suddenly the face become serious now. He says, son, do you have anybody to treat, you know? I said, no, I want to collect it, dry it for future. They said, no such thing, you know. When you have no patience, do not collect the herbs. I see someone will collect it. Someone collect it. Someone's issue, you know. They need it, they collect it now. We at the herbalist, we don't touch a herb when we do not need it, you know. First thing first. They are the, environmentalists, no. Today you talk about environmentalists. I think they are the hardcore environmentalists, no. They don't touch a herb when they doesn't need it, no. So this group of fast herbalists, they don't keep dry herbs. Whenever they need a herb, they go to the wild and they collect it, then they trade. And this tradition is already very few, you know. It dying now, the whole village. I think I'm the only one who continue to practice fractures. I still remember many years ago, there's a group professor coming from one university from California, America, you know. Some American. They come to my village, I talk about him, about this thing. Then I treat them the herbal tree, you know. I planted this thing, they say, wow, good tea, you know, where do you get a tea? I say, it's from the farm now. We just collect it and make into tea, you know. Okay. Then I tell you the story of my father, they collect this thing. They say, wow, this kind of tradition no one practices before, you know. And before they left, you know, they say, Lim, you have to promise me one thing. I say, what? Do not let the tradition die off now. Do not date that, you must continue the tradition. So today I come up with this video to continue this tradition. Okay, so being a herbalist now doesn't mean that you have to go to the pharmacy, you have to go and spend a lot of money to buy. No. You go beside your house, you go to the, you know, park. So my father, the whole this railway is his pharmacy, you know. You get this thing. You talk about the Uncle Chong. Okay, Uncle Chong. The Uncle Chong, he opened a very small small shop, this thing, and he have a torchlight with 6 battery. At that time, a torchlight only 1 or 2 battery. No, 6 battery is a very strong torchlight. Why? Because sometimes middle of the night, people knock at his house. No, okay, to this thing. One day, about 2 o'clock early in the morning, no, someone urgently knocked at the door. No, he ask what happened. They say the son suffering from this throat infection. This tropical throat infection are very risky, you know. Sometimes the throat swollen up. So when it closed out the air package, it can be fatal. The child may die, you know. It's very serious, no. It's okay. No problem. Okay. Then together with the son, you know, they go along the railway, they collected the herbs, no. I'll tell you the herbs in the next video. They collect these herbs, no. Then go to the house, pound it with vinegar. Pow thing, then put it into the clean cloth and put inside the mouth of the child. And he sit there. He tell the parent, no worry. He say, don't worry about that, you know. Within 20 minutes we can know. If the treatment is good, it's good. It's not good, never mind. We still have some other method to this thing. So he pacified the family. Now, the family also know he will not accept any money, you know. You next to me. But Uncle Chong had one weak point. Oh, he loved beer, and he loved this black mouth beer, the stout. Okay, then the parents of the child told him, now you come to my house first as a doctor to my child, and you also my guest, no? Okay, I have to bring you some drink. Then Uncle Chong said, okay, some water for me. Then they bring in the beer stout, no, and pour the stout to him. That one, he cannot resist. No. The thing, no money. He will not accept money, you know. Many years ago, when I working in Mada engineer, one day I go to this coffee house, coffee shop to have some breakfast. Someone calling me, you know. Jing. Jing is my childhood name, you know. Anybody call me Jing must be very close to me. Otherwise, nobody call me with this thing. Hey, sir, I took it. Oh, yeah, Uncle Chong. Oh, you're here. So I sit down with him, you know, and started to check him. The time he's about 85 years old, you know. And the eye is still clear. He can see me from far away. And the memory is still sharp, you know. And talking also, this other thing. Then the owner of the shop, auntie, you know, say, hey, Is it your accountant? Say, I know him. My uncle Chong. Oh, this the man. This the old man. Is always cracking the honey jot. You know, when he see a beautiful woman coming to the this thing. Oh, crack all the acid jot. You know, everybody laughing. You know, people know him well. You know, he's always smiling. This thing. Then Uncle Chong say, I'm old already. Now 80 years old. You know, sometimes the beautiful lady coming in. I tell them, you're beautiful. What's the problem? No problem. Yeah, everybody also in the nearby. So the customer said, no problem, old man, continue. Very happy old man. Then he told me, I say, Uncle Chong, you still drinking beer? He said, yes, I love beer. No. This sort of thing. You see, my son, you know, every time when he visit me, he bring 2 crates of beer to me, you know. But I take 2 bottles a day. And later on, he asked me, can you send me home? I said, sure, I can send you home, you know. But the time I'm driving Volkswagen, not a very good car. So I told him, I drive you back with Volkswagen. So any car is okay for me, don't worry. Then before I go back, he said, okay, I show you 2 of the shop that my son give to me. And his son also later on also become Datuship, a very successful businessman. Okay, I met him a few times, you know. But he's running a very huge timber business. Okay, the son buy 2 shop lot to him. Okay, and let him collect the rental so every month. Okay, so he said, okay, you see, now I have 2 shop lots. Okay, my son give it to me, so I'm not worried about anything now. I can get the rental every month. Happy woman. This thing. So these are the herbalists, my father's, and Uncle Chong. What we learn from them, no? A few things, no? First, they teach without collecting the money. They serve without giving the money. I have big problem, no, when I try to commercialize this get it. My father have a long talk with me, you know. He keep on asking me, son, are you sure you want to sell this thing, no? Are you sure you want to commercialize it? So I told my father, no, that anything good, we must commercialize it. We must commercialize. What is wrong with commercialize? No, this thing, we don't cheat people. No, we sell them at the appropriate price. They buy it, they treat it, we get back some money for the service. What's the problem? No, long discussion. You know, later on when I established DXN, he's still not very agree with me. Okay, and he worked with me for 6 months, no salary. I don't pay you anything. We are too poor, no, to this thing. So they do it free of charge. Secondly, there's strong respect to the herbs, very strong expert. In the early day, when I wanted to establish the DXN, no, I need factory, you know. So we try to search around for some factory lot, everything. The time we didn't have much money, you know. Okay, you have to get something good, cheap. Where to get? Very good. So we searching high road, couldn't get, no. So we were searching until this Sungai Petani, which about 1 hour from our star. When we search here and there, when we go to one very small route, you know, I say, hey, son, stop. I think, hey, anything happened. So I stop at the roadside, you know. Yeah, come. So when we go down, I see roadside, someone had planted this lobata. This tea tau, you know. Okay, this is one of my favorite herd of my father and also the Uncle Chong. Beautifully done, you know. Wow, we planted about 20 to 30 trees. Majestic, you know. He said, son, look at this tree, you know. They are so beautiful. I said, yes, that nice care of the herbs, you know. He said, son, next time when I turn old, okay, I wish to have a garden. I have to plant all the herbs. Later on, I established the accent. Okay, so I have the factory, the farm factory near to the thing. I buy a small plot of land near to the farm factory, you know, and he built his house there. And that house today still, we are still using it for R&D center, you know. So beside the house, there's some small plot of land. Wow, he go and planted whatever herbs he wanted to do. You know, and he know I love groundnuts, no? I like to eat groundnuts. He planted this santong groundnut, no? Huge groundnut, very big one. So every time he come to me, he bring a bag of, hey, son, yeah, this is the groundnut planted by me. They love the soft, they love the herbs, no? This thing. Second person we need to mention is Zhang Zhongqing. He's an author, he's a scholar, author of this Sang Han Lun. I'm going to come up with a series of Sang Han Lun, no? Okay, that will be on another video. Okay, Zhang Zhongqing, he's the father of TCM, traditional Chinese medicine, no? Okay, Now, his time is 150 to 219, almost the same time as Nagarjuna of India. Okay, now both great men had one advantage, one thing similar. Chang Chung Chin established the TCM. Okay, Nagarjuna, this Ayurvedic. Until today, this Ayurveda, this student, they still respect Ayurvedic and one of the founder of this Ayurvedic. So they are almost all the same time, you know. This he record now all the treatment. Okay. It is never easy. The time there's no paper, no. How they record it? They record it on the bamboo. They write it up with ink, but ink very costly, you know. some scholar you don't even have money, you know, to buy the ink. So what they do? They use knife to cave, you know. To cave the woods, this thing. Then after that, use the ash, no, to blacken this. About 390 over sentences, no. This thing. I think to cave the one, it take you years, no. This thing. And sometimes when I prepare the lecture notes, everything, I do a lot of this graphic. Wow, this graphic! I'm not a computer expert, you know. To draw something computer, something that very good. Sometimes I say, oh, this how time. So I am planning, you know. Then I think of Chang Chung Chin. How difficult he is, you know, to put the thing down. The only way put the thing down is to pass down the art, so that people can study it. Today we talk about open source, no. 2,000 years ago, they already know no royalty, you know. Just pass to anybody who wanted to learn, you know. Okay, he gained nothing from that. His son and daughter, everything, nobody gained from that, you know. Just like my father's, no. This do it for free, so that I'll make sure that this herbal series, no, the teaching is free. Only thing when you come for the hotel, you come for this thing, the material may not be free. You want to buy books, everything, you have to pay. But the teaching itself is free. We will not charge anything on the theory. Then from there, and he set up the proper theory, you know, the six section theory, okay, and the meridian theories and all these things. We're going to talk about him in this Sanghan Lun, no. I'm going to come up with a series of Sanghan Lun, this thing. And you should understand him in the preface, no. In the preface, he mentioned it very clearly. Everybody should learn herbs, no. This thing. Secondly, he said you must diagnose and apply the herbs, no, not simply by guessing by this thing, and don't go for saman, go for this kind of split or this thing, no. And today, you know, you see those idiots, no, they're using pendulum, using some sticks or this thing, try to diagnose, no, without looking at you, without taking your pulse, because look at the tongue, you know, how to diagnose a person, you know, this thing. So we must respect, you know, the scholar from ancient time. Even that time also, they tell you don't go for the spray, don't go for the so-called energy treatment, everything. You must diagnose, you must study, you must diagnose the thing. So you must study the symptom, must study this thing. My father, they are simple herbalists, no? Certain simple system, this thing. But when come to the complete theory of this thing, then you must go for Chang Chung Ching. Okay, this thing. So we are going to, so today is the first chapter on herbs, no? In the first chapter, we don't talk about herbs, no? We talk about the basic concept. First thing first, love the herbs and respect the herbs. To a herbalist, no, a cucumber and a ginseng. Ginseng may be high class, ginseng may be costly, cucumber is cheap, no. It is of the same status. This thing. There's no such thing. One herb is higher than the other. No such thing, no. Secondly, we as a herbalist, okay, we get herbs from the nature. Beside our house, in our gardens, in the wet market, this is the thing. So last time you need to go to the mountain to collect herbs, to learn herbs, this is a wrong concept, no. Today we go for wet market, and I told my children, you go and get the vegetable, start with vegetable, they also fresh herbs, this thing. So after that, we are going to a series of talks on the herbs, and a diagnosis. So in today we make, now we make some conclusion, okay. You need to learn herbs, to take care of yourself, to take care of parents, to take care of the poor people, the suffering people. Secondly, you do not need to spend a lot of money to go to the pharmacy to buy a very costly health food, everything. Okay, you can get the herbs beside your house. Go to the railway tracks. Go to the villages. When I put the CDPET, I go to CDPET to establish the factory. I bring along my student with Ayurveda, Rajesh, no? Okay, this thing. So we walk along the trek, full of herbs, full of herbs. So herbs is everywhere. Okay, now most importantly is that you must have the heart to serve. Like Uncle Chong, no? 2 o'clock in the morning, people never blink their eyes. Just go collect the herbs, pow, serve. This is the thing. Most importantly is that respect the herb. Respect the environment. Don't go and destroy the environment. Respect the herb. Always say thank you to the herbs. Okay, this thing. Then after this, we are going to start to talk more about that.